Let's click on the X button on the top right side of the Shapley values for original features window and go back to the MLI tab, where we will select the partial dependence plot, which shows the model's prediction for different original values and the features. In this case, on the top left side of the plot, we can see that the feature shown on the screen right now with respect to the average prediction of the credit score for the poor and bad labels is the feature which had the biggest amount of importance. If you are curious, you can change the variable that appears on the horizontal axis from the top left side of the window. You have a couple of feature options, and I will go with the interest rate as for the moment. The green dots show the estimated probability or the average prediction of the credit score to be bad or poor for the corresponding interest rate. For example, if I change the data set so everyone had an interest rate of 5, the average prediction from our model would be about 25%. Overall, the plot shows us that as the interest rate increases slightly, the probability of the credit score becoming bad increases too. Last but not least, let's take a look at our outstanding debt feature for this plot. Here, we can see that the majority of the applications have owners with less than $1,500 of debt not yet paid. Also, please note that an applicant with less than $1,000 is considered pretty secure, as the average prediction of the credit score is pretty low. Additionally, for applications between $1,000 and $1,500, we see that the average prediction of a bad credit score begins increasing, reaching a peak for applications whose applicants have above $1,500. Is this because the behavior of applications with an outstanding debt of over $1,500 proves to be riskier and the credit score worse, or because we do not have enough observations in our data set to generalize well? Do we need to create another experiment for applications with an outstanding debt of over $1,500? These are yet other questions that we need to consider when interpreting the results of an experiment, when improving its output and making it generalize well. But what I know for sure is that if I were an applicant and I knew this information, I would better pay a third of my debt before applying so that I get a better credit score. Also, what I find great about this plot is that you can zoom in on a particular portion of the graph by clicking and dragging the red horizontal line underneath the main partial dependence plot, just like that. You can move the selected red portion around if you wish. The graph is very interactive and I find it very practical too.